हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर द जॉब रोल ऑफ फ्लोरिकल्चर प्रोटेक्टेड कल्टीवेशन टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ क्लास 11th. एज वी स्टडीड सेशन 1 इन प्रीवियस वीडियो अबाउट ग्रोइंग मीडिया एंड इट्स कंपोजिशन, नाउ वी विल लर्न सेशन 2 एंड 3 ऑफ द यूनिट 3 विच कवर द स्टरलाइजेशन ऑफ ग्रोइंग मीडिया एंड प्रिपरेशन ऑफ बेड्स एंड कंटेनर्स फॉर ग्रोइंग क्रॉप्स. Now, let us first understand the sterilization. Sterilization is a process of removal or destruction of all forms of microbial life from media. Now, we will go through the method of sterilization of growing media. Method of sterilization of growing media are soil solarization. In this method, high intense solar radiation is used during summer as a lethal agent for control of insect, pest, disease and weeds through transparent polythene films is known as soil solarization. Soil sterilization by formaldehyde. In this method, soil sterilization is done with the help of formaldehyde, which inhibits the growth of living organism. Third, soil sterilization by hydrogen peroxide. Since the hydrogen peroxide is in liquid form, it can be applied by drip irrigation. The recommended dose is from 30 to 40 ml per square meter. Now, let us see the steps to be followed during bed preparation. In the step 1, we will plow the soil, then add organic and inorganic manures and fertilizers in the soil and mix them thoroughly. For 1 acre land area, we will add organic manure like vermicompost or FYM 3 trucks, rice husk 2 tons, neem cake 1 tons, worn or fish meal 0.25 tons. After that, mix all the above manures and fertilizers and cover it with the polyfilm for solarization for 2-3 weeks. Step 2. In step 2, we will prepare raised bed either mechanically or manually. The dimension of the beds for flower cultivation are bed height 30 to 45 cm, bed width 75 to 90 cm and path width between two beds is 50 cm. Leveled the top of the bed uniformly and place 2 to 3 drip laterals on each beds depending upon the crop. After that, spray of recommended fungicides and insecticides. The bed is ready for transplanting the seedlings. Plants growing containers for greenhouse production. Types of containers. First, polyethylene foam. It resists cracking and also insulates roots against hot and cold temperature both. Second, protrays. Protrays are used for the production of good variety seedlings. They are conceived which help in the proper growth and development of the roots. Polyethylene bags. These are used to grow the shallow rooted crops. Next, plastic pots. Plastic pots are light in weight, strong and flexible, and they are available in different size. At the bottom of these containers, a small hole is provided for proper aeration and drainage. Advantage of using containers. Containers are easy in sanitation and safety of plants. They are used in cultivate, cut flowers. They are easy to manage and reusable. Containers are also used for rooftop gardening. Let us now summarize what we have learned in this session. In this session, we have learned the different types of media, methods of sterilization, procedure of media sterilization, types of containers, and its advantages. Conclusion. So, if you think you are fit for the role of floriculture protected cultivation and want to help the nation by using greenhouse technology and increase productivity in floriculture sector, learn by doing and give your best. That's all. For the session 2 and 3, In next video, we will cover session 1 of unit 4. Till then, enjoy learning.